There is no condemnation as you are in Christ. There is no any condemnation over your life. Live free, people of God. There is no any condemnation ahead. If you are in Christ, heaven will be your portion. The glory of God will be your portion. Oh, glory to Jesus. And your name is written in the book of life. No one can take it off. Because God is a king. When a king writes, it's unchangeable. The writing of the king cannot be changed. And remember, God does not make a mistake. He wrote your names in the book of life to show that you are saved. You passed from darkness to light, from death to life. There is no any judgment ahead. Oh, no one will take you to the court, spiritual court somewhere. What we are waiting for is the coming of our Jesus. Paul understood those things. In Colossians chapter 1, verse 21, up to 26, he understood those things. He said, for me to live is Christ, and to die is again, because I'm going to rest. Churches are giving me too much sorrows. I want to rest with God. And that's a better thing to do. You want to be in paradise. Hello. The armed robber on the cross. Jesus told him what? He accepted Jesus on the cross. Jesus told him what? Today! And that today, if you hear his voice, just believe in him, you will pass from death to life. Hello?
Amen.
People of God, God's testimony is this: you have eternal life. 1 John, for those who want to write, chapter 5, from verse 9 up to 13. No, 9 to 12 is fine. No, from 9 to 12 is fine. Not 25, 12. Glory to Jesus. John said this. Why John wrote a lot about love? Because he understood that he was God beloved. He understood the love of God upon his life. That why he's the only one who resisted closer to the cross. All the disciples ran away. There were only women with the mother of John and the mother of Jesus and some women from Galilee who were attending to Jesus resisted. Peter ran away. Hello?
Amen.
Glory to Jesus. The one who was promising Jesus, Lord, where are you going? We will go together. We will die together. We will go to prison together. He ran away. John, who understood the love of the Savior, was there. When Jesus was end on the cross, John was there. Glory to Jesus. Glory to Jesus. Jesus told John, showing a mother, said, John, this is your mother. Take care of Mary. I'm doing my assignment. The Father sent me to do. Take care of my mother. Take care of Mary. And told Mary, this is your son. Glory to Jesus. Because John and Jesus, they were very close friends. At the extent, Jesus could lean on the chest of John. Oh, what a love! The Most High God living on the chest of a human being. That's love. Glory to Jesus. That's why Job understood the love. And he wrote a lot about love. Peter ran away from the master. Because Jesus told him, Peter, the devil wanted to kill you, to shift you like a weed. I prayed for you so that your faith may not fail. But when you come back, to me, strengthen your brothers. That's why you see always Peter encouraging. Perseverance, endurance, trials. He knew how he ran away from the master. Glory to Jesus. But John understood the love. Understood our God forgave his sin. Our God will remember no more his sin. He understood from a simple mere fisherman to become an apostle of God. Glory to Jesus. He understood the love of God. He didn't go to any theological school. What is good for Paul and others, but John, Peter, James, they were just simple fishermen, uneducated. Act 4:13. They were not educated. And the God will always choose things neglected in the world, things despised in the world, things rejected in the world, to give value to those things and use them mightily in order to bring to foolishness the wisdom of this world. The wisdom of this world is foolishness before God. God chose to save the world by the preaching of the cross. Glory to Jesus. Greeks are looking for wisdom. All those Socrates, Aristotle, all those people, John Paul, they are looking for wisdom. But the wisdom of this world, James said it's unspiritual, is demonic. Hello? Amen. Glory to Jesus. Is demonic, full of envy and the troubles, the wisdom of this world. Glory to Jesus. But the wisdom of God, God chose. He chose to save the world by the cross. Greek, they don't understand the cross. Jews, they're looking for miracle. But we are seeking Christ crucified. Wisdom of God and the power of God. Are you with me?
Amen.
Glory to Jesus. Your sins are forgiven. Glory to Jesus. God is in eternity. When he decided to forgive your sins, the Bible says all your sins. You don't want to keep some. But God said all your sins. Read well the Bible. Are you reading the Bible? Read it too well. And it's in the past. God forgave our sins. All our sins. Colossians chapter 2 from verse 13 up to 15. All our sins. They were forgiven. It's the reason why Jesus went to the cross. He became a sin so that you may become righteousness of God. Do you think Jesus became sin for fun? No. is to make you right before God. And you are right before God. Not because of what you are doing, because of what Jesus did for you. When you make a mistake, you do something stupid, just repent and go ahead. God is not against you. God is for you. Hello? Why fear? Because we don't understand the love of God, the love God has for us. We are always afraid of judgment. Which judgment? Someone read, can we read Revelation 20 verse 12? No, let us start by 11. And we go down. Revelation 20. From 11 we go down. But the verse is verse 12. Oh, glory to Jesus. Your name are written in the book of life. If you believe in Jesus, your name is written where? In the book of life. Not in other books. In the book of life. And no one can take it out. Glory to Jesus. Moses, when God wanted to finish with Israel, Moses went to the mountain where God called him. The remaining people with Aaron, they made a calf as God. They started to dance and to sing because Israel wanted a God who can walk. The God they can see. And they made an idol. And the law of Moses, you know. When you mix up with the law of Moses, killing will follow. Killing will follow. And the Moses told God, no, don't kill them all. God said, let me finish them and start a new generation with you. Moses told God, if such is the case, just blot out my name in the book of life. No. God has written. When the king writes, it's irrevocable. It will remain forever. Because the king does not make a mistake. The mistake of the king will be considered like a right. I remember the Emperor Napoleon in France made a mistake. Concerning the word sentinel in French. Sentinel. In English, sentinel is what? Security. The king made a mistake. It must be is a masculine word. We call it masculine or what? Because in French, all words, it must be feminine, or I don't know how you pronounce it. Is it masculine and feminine in French? Wait, that's why French is complicated. Because you must know if that word is in feminine or masculine. And the king put it in feminine, they change it in the academy. Because the king does not make a mistake. The mistake of the king becomes automatically right. Glory to Jesus. Now you are never written by God himself. The finger of God has written your name in the book of life. No one can change it. Because God knew you before the knowledge. He knew you before the foreknowledge. Your name are written in the book of life. Those who will be seduced by the Antichrist, you know why? Their names are not in the book of life. Revelation 13 verse 8. The Antichrist will seduce those people whose names are not written in the book of life. The king has written. What is written? He's written. Remember Pilate. He wrote concerning Jesus. He said, "This is the King of Jews." The Sanhedrin of Jews, they told him, "No, change it."